Welcome back to SnowRunner. So we're gonna start working on some tasks and some other things, and let's get this region completed. So I'm gonna head out this way. I'm not doing the hospitality business right now that's up on my screen, but I do want to. There's a couple things I want to go do over this way. Think this is the proper way to go. I'm not sure. I was gonna use my F750, but this is probably the better truck to use for what I'm trying to do, as long as I don't flip it. Damn it. That was probably the best way to go. Probably didn't need to turn gear that way. Now, I don't know. I can't remember if I've gone this way with this truck. I know I went up through the woods once before, but I think I was in my
F750.
I don't know how possible it is to do. Oh my gosh, come on. Why? Just literally goes around. I definitely have gone up through this before and gotten to that road. I just don't know how easy it's gonna be in this big truck, because the woods here definitely suck. They're not very easy to go through, especially with big trucks. Absolutely gonna try it though, because driving all the way around is just gonna take a lot of time. Don't. Alright, we're doing alright. The road's literally right here, so that wasn't too bad at all. Okay, now there is a job up here called Workhorse, which I want to do. There's also one that I have not picked up either that I would like to go pick up, which it is over here, so we're going to go this way. Like, there's still some areas on this map that I haven't actually driven through, because I just was trying to get it defaulted quickly, and There was a couple spots I missed. God, why? This truck literally never flips, and for some reason I just get like super flip happy with it sometimes. I mean, granted, that was pretty much my fault. I mean, I drove up on that bank and tried to turn, which is just gonna roll you over every time, but at the same time, it's just ridiculous. It's a freaking off-road truck. Should have definitely less chance of flipping. But again, I know it's game. I know they're trying to just make it, you know, difficult, I guess you could say. Containers, which they're scattered all around over there. So I need a big trailer for that. Alright, so we're not going to do that right now. We are going to do this, which it is literally right here in that. So let's go out here and get it. And it needs to be delivered over there. It's always a little bit slow going, starting on doing these tasks. And then once you start to knock some of them out, it seems like it tends to go faster. Especially once you kind of learn the map, learn the best routes, and stuff. Has to be. Much easier time. I don't foresee this taking a whole lot more episodes. I should at least, very least, be able to get this completed by, hopefully by the end of this week. And then I am probably just going to take a break from SnowRunner for a bit, just because I don't want to start a new region and then have Star Wars Jedi Survivor come out and then have three games going up at a time. So we're going to probably just put SnowRunner on hiatus until I platinum Star Wars Jedi Survivor, and then we will come back to SnowRunner and just continue on with doing our regions. But like I've said before, my channel is really all about getting platinum trophies, so I already have a platinum trophy for this game. This is really just me completing the game 100% because I want to, and, you know, it's just all the other regions, so. Oops. So I want to do them all. So I figured I'd take you along for the ride. But since I have all the trophies, we'll just take a break from this, and I will get the trophy for Horizon and for Jedi Survivor, and then we will come back to SnowRunner. Do not worry. SnowRunner will return, and we'll keep on trucking. I don't even know if I should be able to go through here. It's just going to be slow. But getting back over to that road is probably the best. Man, I'm really sorry I keep yawning. It's not. It's just. I'm just. Ugh. I am always so tired, I feel like. Like, look, not even moving. God. It, why? I mean, it's just ridiculous. Like, what kind of mud is this? Holy shit, man. Hopefully it's a little more solid over by these trees, because, like, good lord, that sucks there. Am I even moving? Oh my god, you've got to be kidding me. That's just like... I can't pick it up with my crane, can I? I mean, that would be a bit of a joke if I could. God, I hate this crane sometimes. Like, why? The freaking camera angles are just so bad with it sometimes. I hate trying to get a freaking truck on a trailer with a crane like this. Like, why is it going that way? I don't understand this crane. It doesn't make any sense. That's not the way I'm pushing the stick, and it just wants to go that way. So backwards. I mean, I need to be able to winch out of here, so I feel like that's the only way to do this. Because, good lord, this mud is just atrocious. already 50 minutes into this episode and I haven't done a damn thing. Like, good lord. Like, this mud is just so bad. Like, it's amazing to me how much this truck struggles, and like, this truck is literally... Oh, it's not really the way I want to go. Shit. How do I get... I need to get, like, over here somehow. I really don't want to flip. Please don't flip. Have I gotten Big Mistake? No. Should I go grab it? I guess I should. Supposed to be like yeah, I'm pretty sure that's supposed to be the Pennywise house, the red balloons, and like we are in Maine. I'm pretty sure that's what this intention is. I don't want to be here with this music because it's going to get copyright claimed, so we're going to keep driving and keep talking over the music. Alright, there we go. Get away from the media, the radio in the background. I don't want to deal with copyright claim. Alright, we got away. I do remember hearing about that though, that that's like a little nod towards it. Classic Stephen King novel. Because, yeah, it takes place in Derry, Maine. Red balloons, like, and all this makes sense. Okay, now we are on the right track. Let's do this. I'm gonna cut this way. I guess go around there. How we get there, I have no freaking clue. There's no way I go that way. I don't know, we're just gonna have to keep a lookout for like a way to go. Like that's just, I don't see any road on the map. So chances are there's just like a little path that you have to take that just doesn't show up on the map, because that's pretty common, especially on this map. There's a lot of little like routes that just don't show up as roads. I don't think there was a way to go actually. I don't know, there's still no way. There's gotta be a way that I can get across here. I mean, I don't know how deep this water is. I don't know anything. I'm sure there is a simple way to get across. See, look. Yeah, like, there's a road here. But, like, this road doesn't show up on the map. Like, it's so weird. I don't understand why it's like that. Well, it kind of does, I guess. So. I don't know, like that one warehouse from the previous episode where I got the bricks from. Like, I thought that was going to be so much harder to get to. It wasn't hard to get to at all. It was super easy. Yeah, that looks deep as shit. There's no way I'm driving across that. How the hell do I get across? So I can't go that way. I mean, there's some, like, really sketchy looking rock bridges. I don't know, though. I'm kind of at a loss here. I thought... the options I have are, I mean, that, I don't know, that looks crazy. Like, there's no way. I don't even know how you get over there to that. Yeah, pretty much my next point, it's like directly to the left of, I still just like, I don't. I mean, getting over there through that woods would be pretty difficult, but I don't even think that it's something like I could drive across. The only other thing I would think is maybe it's not deep up here and you can get across up there. I mean, that's my hope, because I don't really know what else to do. I don't know how else you get across. Sorry. Across. No, across is not really a word. There's gotta be up here. Seriously, this is gonna be a whole episode of just trying to deliver this freaking truck. Pretty typical. Alright, I need it to be daytime because I can't see shit. Yeah, it looks like this is much shallower, so I think we can probably get across over here. Oh yeah, much shallower here. That wasn't that bad. So, what are we gonna do next? I don't know. We'll figure it out. I'm probably just gonna recover back to the garage at this point, because it's like way out here. if I can, unless there's something else I can do out here, but if I can just recover back to the garage and get a head start going to something else, I would rather do that than drive my way back. Maybe someday if I do a hard mode, I'll have to do that, but... Oh my god, we almost flipped. Okay, I believe it'll just pop out of my truck here. I don't think I have to unload it. Disappeared. Okay, lost in the distance. That's literally right behind the garage. Where does it need to go? I don't know. It's... Oh, that's way over there. I mean, I guess we could try to do that. It's in another one of those fucking awful swamps. We'll be fine. Yeah, we have time. It's just a matter of doing it. Oh shit. But yeah, there's freaking mud swamps are horrible, so I know this isn't going to be fun again, but listen, if I get these done and out of the way, then I don't have to do them later, so. We get it done and we get it out of the way, then we're good to go. Kind of learned the best ways to go across this map. Like it's almost a lot like Tamir, where it kind of wants you to go off the road and not drive on the road and go off the beaten path. Very similar to that. There's a lot of instances where it's better to just drive off roads than on the roads. I basically just need to get here and there we go, here, across here, and once we get this job done. That's at least two jobs we got done, or two tasks. Both vehicle deliveries, but, or vehicle rescues and deliveries. But as long as I get them done, then it just, you know, better that I don't have to do them later. So. I know sometimes things are not the most enjoyable in this game, but once you do actually get it done, and you don't have to worry about it anymore, pretty good. Pretty good feeling. So let's... I don't know. I hope I can get through this swamp not without getting too stuck. I don't know. The freaking truck is all the way on the other side of it, so I'm gonna have to drive through it regardless. Which kind of sucks, but... Thank you. switch to trying to drive with one hand. Doesn't work too well. This up. Just checking. I mean, if I could winch it from far away, that'd be great, but I don't think I'm going to be able to. Oh, man. It's gonna be real bad. If I can pick it up, though, and put it in the truck, it's probably the best thing to do. That way I can still use my winch. I keep pushing the wrong buttons. Almost there. Come on. Let's get over there so I can put this tiny little thing in my bed. Let's get turned around. Go back the way we came. And then this just pretty much needs to be delivered right behind the garage, so it shouldn't be. That difficult of a delivery. We just basically gotta go to the garage and then drive around the back side of it. Kind of like we did at the beginning of the episode. Same spot, really. And that'll probably pretty much be the end of the episode. Which is fine. It's not the greatest episode of all time, but it'll do. I would really love to get out of this mud. I just hate how slow it is. It's the worst. Go. You know, another thing, I really wish you, like, which, I know, granted, it is kind of mimicking real-life physics. But when you go down into water like this, say you're, like, hauling ass, and you crash down into water, it, like, just completely wrecks your momentum. Like, in real life, like, yeah, it would definitely slow your truck down, but you would still carry a lot of momentum through the water. I don't know, it's just, I've always found that kind of odd. Like, anytime you go in water or something, it just immediately basically like sends your truck into a crawl. It's just weird. Across this overly flooded river thing, whatever you want to call it. Alright, I would like to go back the way I came. Like, up that shortcut. I think it's the best way to go. It's gonna cut across. Just because it's, you know, literally right there. There's no sense backtracking. You know, that's nonsense. I should just be able to go straight across here. And I think that's it. That little opening in the trees straight ahead. I think I can go either way. I think I'm gonna try to go to the right side of the garage. Cause I think I'm pretty sure it loops all the way around. Like that little path. You gotta avoid this road here at all costs. That road is absolutely horrendous. Blue snow. Even with the modded truck as powerful as this, you still get stuck. Like, it's not a fun time. It looks like there's a path here. Probably not an easy path. This path. I didn't realize I didn't have it active. Where's my marker? Why do you do this game? I think there's some rock crap coming up here, which is going to be interesting. I don't think I've ever gone this way. Pretty sure I haven't, actually. Oh, jeez. Don't. Oof. Alright, that should be the last of the obstacles. Should be straight on to delivering. So we got two things done. I wish I could have gotten more done, but these weren't exactly the easiest trucks to deliver, so. There it is, done. All right, so with that, I'm gonna end the episode and I will see you in the next one. We will knock out more tasks, hopefully be a little bit more done. And as always, we're just having fun. So. If you leave a like, if you liked it, subscribe if you want to, and I will catch you in the next episode. Have a good one.